I cringe whenever I hear the word standard associated with a Delta E, because there is no standard for it. And I appreciate the spirit of the question, no doubt. I guess what I'd say is that, I would say oftentimes the loose agreement is about a 2 Delta E that we'll hear from customers. And it's not about that we're trying to get away with anything, but obviously the larger the tolerance, the better. But realistically, between 2 and 3 is typically what we see. But again, it goes back to process capability and if that's acceptable. But, one of the things I've done, and it's a little bit of a pain to do sometimes, but when you have a large, say national account that you want to, kind of nail down well, we've produced, even off the press, sample prints, if you will, of a job, purposely pushing that spot color lighter and darker, and then, presenting those to the customer. Don't even tell them the Delta E, and show it to them and say, all right, if this is the standard color, and then you start showing them steps, call it roughly half Delta E steps away from a light and dark point of view, what's acceptable to you? And at some point, they're going to pick one and say, well, that's as dark as I'd want to go, and that's as light as I would want to go. Then you can put numbers on it. And I've had more cases than not where the resulting number ends up being 3, 3.5 Delta E before they object. But again, if you go into cosmetics, they'll be picking out a half a Delta E. So depends on the customer. But again, I think it all ties back into what your process is capable of. And if you can understand that, and there's a lot that goes into it, ink formulation, strength of ink, but everything's going to vary to some level. And it's a matter of trying to communicate that both visually and, colorimetrically or objectively to the customer. And, trying to settle on something that you can hit and that's going to be reasonable for the customer. And if there's a mismatch there, then somebody's got to make some hard decisions there.